Hi, what can I do for you today?
I'm Charlie Warner. I'm looking for Wade Davis.
You're talking to him, my friend. Oh, you're the guy that called this morning, right?
No, you must be thinking of somebody else. We spoke 2 days ago.
Yeah. Yeah, sure. Now I know. Low mileage, one party ownership.
I'm the guy.
Come on, I'll show you the car. On the phone. We're not carrying any paper. Strictly cash.
What's Davis doing out there with the cop?
What are you talking about?
That guy out there is a Wichita cop. He busted my two cousins.
He is the guy that's buying the stuff.
How many times can you step on this?
You can hit this stuff pretty hard. Maybe 6, 8 times.
You just made yourself a deal, Wade.
I think you just made yourself a very big mistake.
Hey, look, fellas, if you're worried about throwing in a new set of tires, I'll take it like it is.
Ralph, what are you doing?
He's a cop. Give me your gun.
Hey, look, don't get stupid. We can work something out.
Just take his damn gun.
You got nothing.
Going around this guy. Get behind him.
Get up and step away.
It's not worth it, Steve.
It's too much paperwork, buddy.
Thanks, Woody. Hey, where you been?
Waldron wanted to see me.
Oh, yeah.
Give me a brandy. Good stuff.
It's pretty expensive taste, buddy.
Hey, I can afford it. I'm sticking you with a bill.
Oh, thanks.
Thank you. It's pretty close out there today.
It sure was.
What were you doing out there, anyway?
Well, a snitch I work with told me something was going down. I thought I'd be there.
Wait a minute. You went out there to make a bust? My bust? I don't even work vice.
So when does that matter?
It was my bust.
Well, you should have had a backup.
I didn't have time. Who was your backup?
I didn't have time either.
We're gonna feel like old times, Stark. I always said we were like two sides of the same coin, remember?
I remember.
Sometimes I wonder if I made the right choice. Switching to vice. Times were different then. Simpler. Ever feel that way?
Sometimes, try not to think about it. How's Claire?
You know, Claire never changes. She misses you.
Oh, yeah?
Three of us have got to go out to dinner sometime.
You buying?
Look, I got to get out of here. Look, I'll call you in a couple of days and we'll go out for steaks,
hey,
all right?
Where are you going?
I'm meeting some guy who was supposed to give me some information about a big coke shipment coming in from KC. It's probably a waste of time, but I figure what the hell is worth 20 minutes to find out. Look, I'll call you.
Yeah. Hey, Steve. You take care of yourself, cowboy.
Hey, don't worry. If I get into trouble, I'll call for backup.
You got it.
Right?
Well, you're late, not cold. What you got better be good.
You should be careful who you step out with.
Air 10, meet 7 by 87 on track 2, over. Air 10, roger. All units 7085, come 6 on
Hauser. We're doing the autopsy.
All right, this is right away. All right, I want it stacked. I want that car. Close up with a shotgun. I'm getting too old for this kind of thing. You got any idea why he was out here?
No. He had drinks earlier. He said he was going to meet some guy who had information about a coke buy.
Damn!
Hey, Tom, give me some light over here.
Let's go for a walk. This one's yours if you want it. Before you say yes, because that's what I know you're gonna say. It's something you ought to know. Steve was under investigation by the IAD.
For what?
A couple of months ago, we busted a fence. He was peddling stuff that disappeared from our impound. The guy wanted to roll over, and he gave Steve's name to us.
You should have told me. He was my friend. I had a right to know that, Chief.
You didn't have a right to know anything till I knew. You want the job or not?
You know I do.
Then go find out who killed him.
One more thing, Chief.
I'm listening.
I don't want to be looking over my shoulder, so keep IAD off my back.
Steve turns out to be dirty, IAD be all over us.
I know. You're going to take most of the heat.
Well, it won't be the first time.
Thanks, Chief.
Maggie there? Got the wrong number. Sorry.
What was that?
Wrong number.
We've had happier days, haven't we?
Yeah.
Well, can I get you anything, coffee?
No, I'm just had some coffee.
Can you sit for a few minutes?
Sure. Bobby.
At school. I thought it would be best if you were with friends. Look, I know you have to ask me some questions. It's okay.
Is there anything you can tell us? Did Steve say anything that could help us?
Steve was never one to take his work home. You know that.
Yeah. Was he edgy or nervous?
A little. He was gone a lot. For some reason, he had a lot of stakeout duty this year.
Really? How often?
Once a month, 2 or 3 days at a time. He went to Las Vegas twice. Only for a few days. He liked to gamble. He said it relaxed him. Didn't he tell you about his trips?
We worked on different cases. We let things get in the way.
He cared about you.
Me too. I'll miss him. Still on vacation?
Yeah, why?
Just checking. Del Vecchio, you got that duty roster for me?
Right here. Hey, you know how long it took to compile that? I had to work half the night.
Put yourself in for overtime.
Hey, you're all hard, Stark.
And I also want you to be brief as possible and have it signed and back to my chambers as soon as possible.
Morning, Stark.
Morning, Judge.
Don't knock, just come in and sit down.
I'm going to Vegas.
Again? Thought you didn't like Vegas.
Yeah, after a while it grows on you, Chief.
Aside from the fact this town seems to draw you like a magnet, why Vegas?
It's the only thing that makes any sense. I found these in Steve's desk drawer.
So?
There's more. Claire tells me that he went to Vegas to unwind and that he had 2 or 3 day stakeouts on the average of once a month. Here's the duty roster for the past year. Steve never had a stakeout more than twice.
Sounds pretty thin to me, Evan.
Come on, Chief. He had to go someplace. I haven't found anything in there that would justify a hit. Vegas is a fast town.
Maybe he was into something he didn't want anybody to know about.
Vegas, huh?
Yeah. I think that's where the answers are.
My poor heart is sentimental, not made of wood. I got a friend that ain't good. But when the weekend's over,
you're like a summer call, Stark. I can't seem to shake you.
Well, good morning to you too, Lieutenant. How did you find me?
Well, with a top-notch police force, the latest in technology, I guess we just got lucky.
Waldron called you, huh?
Like I said, we just got lucky. Keeping late hours, aren't you, Stark?
Waldron called you. You must know why I'm here. Any help you could give me, I'd appreciate it.
I figured you were gonna ask. I did some checking. Your friend Steve Graves is a non-person. No record of him ever being here. There's no hotel reservations, no auto rentals, no gambling debts.
Could have used an alias.
Well, if he did, it's gonna make it a lot harder. I'm sorry about your friend. But I'm warning you now, Stark. If there's any investigating to do, we'll do it. In the meantime, you leave people alone. Especially casino people.
You can count on me, Lieutenant.
That's what you said last time.
Got the job done last time.
Thank you.
Miss Carter, my name is Evan Stark. I'm a police officer. I'd like to ask you some questions.
Come on up!
Hello?
I assume you have some identification?
Oh, yeah, sure. Here you go.
Wichita, Kansas. You're a little out of your jurisdiction, don't you think, Toto?
I'm investigating a murder.
Whose?
I'd feel a whole lot better discussing this without a chain door between us.
Make it quick. I don't have all day.
Yeah, well, this won't take long. Does the name Steve Graves mean anything to you?
No.
A police officer from Wichita, Kansas, who was killed. Found that in his desk drawer.
A lot of people have these. Hotel hands them out like popcorn.
You may know him by another name.
I do know him. Not well. He told me his name was Steve Lerner. I had a drink with him one night after the show. We didn't even leave the hotel.
When was the last time you saw him?
A couple of months ago.
Where did you two go?
We didn't go anywhere. We had a drink at the hotel, just like I said a couple of seconds ago. Is this a trick quiz?
Sorry. Just trying to get everything straight. Mind if I use your phone? It's a local call.
Live it up.
Thanks. Yeah, this is Stark. Tell Lieutenant Bliss I'll meet him in about an hour. That's right. Thank you. Thanks for your help. Oh, don't put yourself out. I'll find my way out.
Have a nice day.
Welcome back.
Aaron Brown, please dial 28. Aaron Brown, 28, please.
Is this seat taken or can anyone sit here?
Anyone can sit here. Want something to eat?
No, I'm not hungry.
Consider yourself lucky. So why is it I never hear from you when there's good news?
Maybe it's the nature of my job. Good to see you, Lee.
Yeah, you too, Stark. Look, what I'm doing isn't exactly kosher, so please try to exercise a little discretion, all right?
What did you find out?
Well, being an entertainment director, you hear things. There was a guy named Steve Lerner. Came to town once a month, used to throw a lot of money around. Guy must have been like catnip to the ladies, because he had a lot of them.
What kind of ladies? Married, single, divorced, what?
What am I, a computer? Wait a minute, I'm giving you information here, Stark, not a printout. Well, I hear he was seeing two women at the same time. It was a fight or something, because one of them got beaten up.
Lee Vogel, please dial 68.
Believe this, I can't even get heartburn in peace.
Lee Vogel, 68, please.
Look, I don't have a last name. Only Allison. She's a dancer. She works here at the Sands.
Appreciate this, Lee.
Hey, like I always say, a friend in need is a pest.
I'm looking for a dancer named Allison.
Yeah, I think she's in the dressing room.
be okay. Yes.
Coming through.
I got the best from this.
That's cute.
Yeah.
Allison.
Over there.
At a Lorraine.
Did you really? Oh, you're
Hi.
Who are you?
I'm a police officer. Ask you some questions.
What about?
Steve Lerner.
Just wait, I'm right about to go on in a few minutes.
A few minutes, I'm going to get thrown out of here. What was your relationship with Steve?
We dated for a while.
How well do you know Maggie Carter?
She's my... What's this about, anyway?
Just want to get some information, that's all.
Look, I'm sorry the guy's dead,
I didn't know he was dead.
Knew.
Places, everybody. Places, please.
Do you just...
I didn't say anything, Alice.
Really, I have to go.
You supposed to be here?
Not really.
That's what I thought.
I didn't need your help getting in, and I don't need your help getting out.
Life move again, in the groove again, taking a chance on love. I walk around with a horseshoe in clover, I lie, and brother rabbit, of course you better kiss your foot goodbye. On the ball again, I'm riding for the fall again, I'm gonna give my
You didn't tell me diddly. Graves kept a picture of you in his desk drawer. Supposed to be going out with two women at the same time. One of them was a dancer named Allison.
So
one of them got beaten up real bad. And you have a picture of you and Allison in your apartment looking real chummy. You two work together, is that it? Is that where Steve's money was going? Maybe it got a little kinky, a little out of hand. Is that it?
Watch my lips. Allison and I never were going out with Graves or Lerner, whatever the hell his name was, at the same time. I would never do that to Allison. And the reason for that, and the reason her picture is in my apartment, is because we're sisters, jerk face.
save me a trip. I was just going looking for you.
I'm flattered.
Don't be. Maggie Carter, casino employee, filed a complaint against you. I told you, stay away from casino people.
Lieutenant, I like the desert air. I'm not here for my health.
You listen to me, mister. You're a cop without jurisdiction. You're hassling people in a town where the crime wasn't even committed.
I'm not going anywhere until I get some answers. For starters, I need to know the name that's listed for this number. Now, come on, Lieutenant. I know you think I'm a hayseed from Kansas. I need your help. We're both cops. Maggie Carter has a sister named Allison. I need stats on both of them.
Kenneth Clayton. Address reads like money. I'll see what I can do about the sisters. All right?
You're okay, Lieutenant.
Don't make me sorry, Stark.
Did you buy it or browbeat someone for it?
Browbeat.
Sure. How's your face?
Fine. Your hand?
Sore. Have a seat.
Listen, I'm sorry about last night.
What do you need?
I need some straight answers. Allison dated Steve and knew he'd been killed. Now, I didn't tell her that.
I did.
You did?
Yeah, I called her and told her that you might stop by and ask a few questions. Well, I wanted to protect her. She's kind of fragile and unstable.
In what way?
I might as well tell you because you're going to find out anyway. Allison had a nervous breakdown a couple of years ago. She got involved with some people. She got real strung out.
Did Allison and Steve do drugs?
I don't know. We don't talk that much. Allison and I have this competitive thing between us. And we even have different last names. Hers is Cromwell. It's all very stupid.
Thanks for telling me this. I know you didn't have to.
You do me a favor? If your investigation leads back to Allison for any reason, will you let me know?
Ask a lot.
I expect a lot. Kansas.
Okay.
I'll walk you to the door.
Flesh speaking.
It's your favorite cop from Wichita.
I have some information for you on Clayton. No surprises. He's a wealthy businessman, does a lot of traveling, no criminal record.
Married?
Wife's name's Jennifer.
Have nothing on Maggie Carter. No sister named Allison.
They have a different last name. It's Cromwell.
Cromwell. You know, this is a different experience for me.
Two of us actually working together.
You have anybody following me?
No, why?
No reason. I gotta go.
Stark.
Was following you.
Have a nice day, Lieutenant. The interior is fine. Just a light rinse will do. Drive it in. You must be bashful. You've been following me all morning. Haven't introduced yourself.
It's not what you think it is.
What is it?
I'm a private detective.
Convince me.
My ID's in my coat. Can I get it?
No, I will. Chester Moonchase, private investigator. Who are you working for?
I can't tell you that. That's privileged.
So's living, Chester.
Allison Cromwell.
Office. You decorated yourself. Sit down. We're gonna have a little talk. I have some questions and you have some answers. See if we can match them up.
This is illegal. I got my rights.
You want to file a complaint? I'm a police officer in an official investigation and you're impeding my progress. You also could be suspect in a murder case.
What murder?
You didn't know about that, did you, Chester? A police officer by the name of Steve Graves was killed in Wichita, Kansas. Gunned down by a hitman. You know any hitmen?
You're crazy, you know that?
Talk to me, Chester.
How'd you spot me anyway? I was so careful. Oh, it was the car, wasn't it? It's too bright.
No, car's fine. You just had a bad day.
Well, I didn't know anything about a murder. What do you want to know?
When did Allison hire you?
Which time? Well, this is the second time I worked for her.
Explain.
The first time was a couple of months ago. She hired me to follow a guy named Lerner. She had a real thing for him. She thought he was seeing somebody else.
Was he?
You bet.
Wasn't Jennifer Clayton, was it?
Yeah, how'd you know?
Lucky guess. How did Allison react when you told her about Jennifer?
Well, she was kind of cold about it. She thanked me, paid me. I thought that was the end of it. Then she hired me to follow you. She said she just wanted to know what you were up to. Well, that's all I know. Honest.
All right, Chester. If you remember anything else, I'm at the Vegas Palms Motel. One more thing. You might want to try another line of work.
Wichita Police, Sergeant Luchansky speaking.
Luchansky, Stark. Give me the chief.
Stark, we've been looking all over for you. Where have you been?
Investigating murder. Did that slip your mind?
Look, you gotta get back here right away. IAD wants you for a deposition.
Yeah, well, they'll have to wait.
Lots of things are coming out about Steve's death, and it could affect the whole department all the way up. They even took a deposition from Waldron.
Waldron? Let me talk to him.
Yeah, well, that's another thing. Waldron's in the hospital. Dr. Strange is CPU's death.
place to take a vacation. How you feeling anyway?
I don't feel 20 anymore.
I brought you some magazines. What are you doing in here anyway?
Clock's been a little bit off. Some young doctor, he's not old enough to shave, he wants to do some tests. No big deal. It's been planned for a while.
So? Why all the secrecy?
Oh, listen, we got enough trouble down the department as is.
Shansky says that Steve's death is going to involve the whole department.
You know, that bus Steve had at the used car lot, I don't think he went down there to arrest him. I think he went down there to get in the business. We're talking a lot of dollars here. Thousands, maybe hundreds of thousands, I don't know. It's my department, Evan. The wheels of that big political machine are beginning to turn already.
What's that supposed to mean?
I wear a size 13 shoe, kid. I stepped on a lot of toes with them. They want to use it to get rid of me. They'd do anything to get me to retire.
Listen, Chief, your record speaks for itself. Don't let it fresh you.
Come here.
What?
Come here. I don't want to talk too loud. What they don't know yet is I'm going to let them convince me. Evan, I've been a cop for 30 years. I'm getting tired. But I want to go out clean, you understand? I don't want to go out with all this dirty. So I want you to find out who killed Steve. And if it has anything to do with corruption, you understand me? I want you to find out.
I'll find out for you, Chief. I promise. Just take care of yourself.
Evan.
Yeah?
You always been a good kid. Huh? Now you're a pain in the butt sometimes, but I always knew I could depend on you. You made me proud.
Don't worry about a thing, Chief. Just get better.
What else can I do? I'm in a hospital.
Like your style, Stark. First cabin all the way.
Plane came in at a bad time. I got tired waiting for a cab. How'd you know I'd be here?
I missed you at the airport. Figured I'd catch you downtown.
You always wake up this early to welcome back visitors, or am I something special?
It's something special. There's no easy way to do this, so I'm just gonna get to it. Your chief is dead. He had a massive coronary.
Well, you were headed back. Wichita thinks you're wasting your time. They want you back. No. I made a promise to Waldron.
You gotta do what you think is right. But you might reconsider.
You got any more news for me?
I don't know whether it means much. Last time Graves was in town, he got in a fight with Clayton. He slapped him around at a private party. A lot of people saw it.
Clayton got slapped around.
A slap in the face is no reason to kill a person. I gotta go back to headquarters now. You want me to drop you someplace?
No. I'll call you.
They told me that Waldron was like a father to you. I'm truly sorry, Evan.
You call me.
Pecan buns, a customer wants to know.
I baked them this morning, ma'am. If they were any fresher, they'd jump up and bite you.
Mrs. Clayton?
Yeah?
My name is Sergeant Stark. I'm a police officer. I need to ask you some questions about a man named Steve Graves. You know him as Steve Lerner. Nice animal. Mrs. Clayton, Graves was murdered.
Who told you about me?
Private investigator. Told me you were having an affair with Graves.
Was his name Moonchase?
Yeah, how do you know?
He tried to blackmail me when he found out about my relationship with Graves. He threatened to tell my husband.
How much money did he want?
$10,000.
Oh, that's not very much money for you, Mrs. Clayton, is it?
He was a little man.
You pay him?
Never came to that. Somebody else told Kenneth.
And he beat you up?
I have the feeling we're doing some kind of mating dance here.
Your husband did beat you up.
It had never happened before, and it'll never happen again. I hurt him, okay?
Bet you hurt a lot of people.
Not the smart ones.
What about Steve? Was he smart?
Very smart. And sexy, too.
You two do any drugs, any cocaine, that sort of thing?
You dabbled. Make it more exciting.
What about your husband? Does he dabble?
My husband does not believe in that. He can be pretty Victorian.
But not you. You like to have a good time, don't you?
So did Graves. He liked women like me because we're exciting. The more danger, the more excitement. I think he thought he was invincible. But no one's invincible, are they, Sergeant?
No, Mrs. Clayton. No one is.
And then Jack said, everybody dies, and all death affects us equally. But I don't agree with that. I think the greatest loss to bear is that of a child. It's an affront to logic and nature. And because it's your heart that beats in that child, a part of you dies along with it.
Good work, everybody. See you Thursday.
Hi.
You just pop up all the time, don't you?
You're pretty darn good, you know that?
How long have you been sitting out there?
Long enough to be impressed.
I am so embarrassed. Something wrong?
What?
I could see something in your face.
Oh, I had a rough couple of days. My chief back in Wichita died.
I'm sorry. Were you too close?
Yeah, we were. He wanted to know if things led back to Allison. Well, they have. She hired a private investigator to spy on Graves and to follow me.
Oh, that's just great. So what are you going to do now?
I'm going to talk to her, Maggie.
I'll go with you.
No.
Look, you don't know Allison. You'll come on like a bull in a china closet, and she'll get defensive and hysterical and psychotic, and you'll get nowhere. I've seen you in action, remember?
You doing anything tonight?
Nothing.
My sister was a dancer. She worked at the Dunes.
Really? What's her name? Maybe I know her.
Her name was Laura. She died a year ago.
Las Vegas doesn't hold very nice memories for you, does it?
What about you? How long have you been out here?
My whole life. I was raised here.
Yeah?
What?
What?
What's so funny?
Oh, nothing. I just didn't think anybody was raised here. I thought they all came here from someplace else.
Las Vegas can actually be a very nice place to live. Probably about as nice as Wichita.
What about your family? What did they do?
I don't know much about my mother. I know she ran off with a trumpet player.
Sorry.
And so I became the mother. I think Allison needed that. I think she resented it at the same time.
Your dad?
My dad was a gentle failure. He wanted to be Bob Hope, but instead he became a night watchman at an ice house. So how about you, Stark? Do you have any deep, dark secrets you'd like to tell me about?
I'm sorry to disappoint you. I was born in Wichita. I grew up in Wichita. I became a cop in Wichita.
Like Steve Graves.
That's right. We had a lot in common.
No, you didn't. He's scum. He turned Allison onto drugs again. Not a lot, just enough.
Why didn't you tell me this before?
What, do I look like your deputy?
Look, if you hold back information, I can't help you.
You came here to arrest someone. Do you want me to put the handcuffs on her myself?
Oh, you think that's what this is all about?
I know that's what this is all about. She is my sister.
Look, what? I'll tell you something about... I know something about sisters. My sister was murdered because she was hanging out with the wrong kind of people.
You're trying to scare me. It's working. Allison and I don't have this great relationship. She's all I've got left, so I don't want anything to happen to her.
Neither do I, Maggie. Neither do I.
Good. We have one thing in common. I'm sorry if I got out of line earlier.
I was the one out of line.
No. We were both out of line. It's your move, Stark. Good kisser. Where'd you learn that?
Wichita.
There's a lot to be said for Wichita. I would invite you in, but I have a show to do tonight. So maybe I'll see you tomorrow.
Yeah.
See ya.
See ya. Tomorrow.
I should be back tomorrow. Day after at the latest. Is everything okay with you?
Somebody killed Steve Lerner. Was it you?
What kind of a question is that?
Just answer me, was it?
No, Jennifer, it wasn't. I'm a businessman. I don't kill people. I'll call you from L.A.
You're close, but no cigar. Take 10, catch your breath, then we'll come back and get it right.
A minute.
Look, I already told you everything I had to.
Not quite. I know about Chester Moonchase.
Well, aren't you the clever little detective?
Allison, just listen to me.
What else do you know?
I know you hired Moonchase a second time because you were afraid I'd find out something you didn't want me to know. Something about Jennifer Clayton.
What are you talking about?
No, let him finish. He's on a roll.
Jennifer Clayton got beaten up because her husband found out she was having an affair. Somebody had to have told him. That was you, wasn't it? I want to help you, Allison.
Damn you, Stark. I'm not some flaky little dancer who gets all crazy because she can't handle her jealousies. I loved him, and he dumped me. I may have wished he was dead, but I never would have killed him. So you better start barking up another tree.
Well, that's it for me, Donna. I'm going home.
You got anything planned for tonight?
Yeah, I got a date.
Lucky you.
Luck had nothing to do with it.
As per our conversation last Thursday, I'm mailing the photographs detailing your partner's gambling activities. I will, of course, keep the negatives until I receive your payment. I'll be with you in just a minute. Well, you're Mr. Baker, right?
That's right.
I'm just finishing up some dictation.
No hurry. Is that where you keep all your records?
Yeah, why?
It'll save me some time.
You said on the phone you had domestic problems.
No, I didn't say they were mine. Turns out they're yours.
Pretty good out there today. Glad those dancing lessons paid off.
Thank you.
And watch turnover. Call in, please.
Liz still in?
Stark from Wichita, right?
Right.
There's a call out for you. The lieutenant wants you to meet him.
Where?
The morgue. 1704 Pinto Lane.
Got it.
I want to know everything about him, including his credit ratings. You start looking for possibles that like to use a knife.
Who is it?
A private eye named Moonchase. He had a slip of paper in his pocket with your name on it. You mind telling me how you know him?
Look, it had to do with Graves. How was he killed?
A knife. And whoever did it was good. Killer burnt the files. My guess is that he went to hide a motive.
Or clean house.
Hey, where are you going?
Make a phone call.
I need you for a possible identification.
Later! Please answer. Come on.
An autopsy tonight. We run a test on what's left
Forget
in the body.
About the autopsy, just find out where Kenneth Clayton was.
Kenneth Clayton. How many times I have to tell you, people do not commit murder because of a
Graves,
slap in the face.
Graves, Allison, Moonchase, all connected with Clayton. Don't tell me that's a coincidence, Lieutenant.
But why?
Why? Because Graves was involved with drugs. Maybe it had something to do with that.
Maybe. Maybe.
Excuse me, you can't come in here. I'm sorry, you can't
I'm
come in.
I'm her sister.
Just a moment.
Excuse me, Lieutenant.
All right, officer. I'm sorry, Maggie.
One shot. I just want to see you.
This magazine is here when you guys got here.
We don't know yet. Let me take you home.
I don't want to go home.
Maggie, there's nothing you can do here.
Are you sure she's dead? Because, you know, sometimes they can
make a mistake. Yes, we're sure. Come on, let me drive you home. Come on.
Is it all right if I take this?
I can't allow that to leave now.
It's just family pictures.
Maybe you can make an exception. Just this once, Lieutenant.
I think I'm gonna have some coffee.
You don't need any coffee. Where do you keep the booze?
I keep it in that cabinet. Should I make some phone calls now?
There's plenty of time for that later.
Aren't I supposed to be making arrangements? I don't know what I'm doing. Laura, when she died?
23.
That's just a year younger than Alice. You know how I feel, don't you?
I didn't want this to happen. I wish I could change it.
fine. I think I just need to be alone for a little while.
I'll call you in the morning, right?
Could you stay with me tonight? You don't have to do anything or anything. But do you think you could just be with me?
Morning.
Morning. Coffee's on.
I just want to thank you.
You haven't had my coffee yet.
You know what I mean. Yes?
Lieutenant Bliss.
Come on up. He doesn't waste any time, does he? You look terrible. Did you get any sleep?
Some. How are you feeling?
Better. Allison and I used to trade this back and forth all the time. Started out when we were little kids. What's the name of the detective Allison hired?
Moonchase. He was killed yesterday.
What is it?
It's a client's copy of Moonchase's investigation.
Just a minute.
Put it away.
Sergeant Stark here.
Sure, come on in. Help yourself to some coffee.
Thank you. Good morning, Sergeant.
You look terrible.
Oh, I should. I've been up most of the night, if not all of it. I went by your place looking for you. I think you ought to know what we have here. Thank you. First of all, there are no latent fingerprints found at your sister's apartment. No sign of a struggle, no breaking and entering.
What does that mean?
Means they can't prove anybody else was there. What else?
The medical examiner's still running tests, but it appears that she died of a large overdose of a strong barbiturate. That plus 100 proof vodka accelerated a Coleman death.
You see, Allison didn't even drink. She hated the taste of booze.
What about Clayton?
He was in Los Angeles. Lots of witnesses. Spent the night there, flew back this morning. He's clean with a capital C. We know about your sister's emotional history.
So what does it have to do with this?
It leads our preliminary findings to death by suicide.
My sister did not kill herself.
Lieutenant, I think we need to...
Sergeant, can I talk to you alone now? It's outside.
All right. Be right back.
Your Internal Affairs Department has ordered you back effective immediately.
I've been given a lot of orders in my lifetime, Lieutenant. I don't always follow them.
I got the feeling that this one's chiseled in stone.
Look, why don't you call them on my behalf? Tell them how important I am to your investigation.
Aren't you listening to me? You've been ordered back by Internal Affairs. This is your department, Evan. It's not mine. I'm sorry to be the one that has to tell you. I'll keep you posted. Miss Carter, one of my men dropped your car off. These are your keys.
Thanks.
I'll let you know what's happening.
I'll be back, Lieutenant. You can count on it.
So what was that all about?
I've been ordered home. My department doesn't believe this has anything to do with Steve Graves' death. I think he was involved in a cocaine ring in Wichita. And that's the reason he got murdered.
Allison did not commit suicide. Look, it's all right here. Graves, Allison, Moonchase. And the only one connected to all three is Kenneth Clayton. He's just going to get away with this, isn't he? Because nobody's going to do anything about it.
I won't let you down. I promise. I'll speak to you in a couple of days.
Hello?
Kenneth Clayton?
Yes?
My name is Maggie. I have something you might be interested in.
What's that?
A confidential report written by Chester Moonchase. It links you to three murders. I want $50,000... I want you to meet me in 2 hours or I go to the police.
Where?
There's an old ice house on Regent and 8th. It's going to be torn down. I'll meet you there.
Ice house, Regent and 8th.
Don't lie to me. I'm running out of time.
I don't know where.
Three people are dead already. How many more have to die for you?
Somebody called. I don't know who.
They're going to meet at the old ice house. Regent and 8th.
The little bear said, there's nothing to be scared of. Because
This is the magic forest where the best of...
Maggie? Kenneth Clayton.
Not what I expected.
What did you expect?
We used to play here. Some nights Daddy couldn't get a babysitter, so we'd sleep on the cot, and then he'd just take us home with him in the morning. He used to spend the night walking the building, which left us alone, and Allison was afraid of the dark. So I used to lie down next to her, and I'd tell her stories so she wouldn't be afraid.
We have some business to discuss, Maggie.
You murdered my sister, you bastard.
I don't know what you are talking about.
To bring the money?
It's right here.
For a man who doesn't know much about murder, you're willing to pay a lot.
I'm paying because I'm a businessman. I can't afford bad publicity. My wife got involved with someone she shouldn't have, and that kind of notoriety can hurt me financially.
Cost of doing business.
Exactly.
So why should I believe you?
If I were what you think I am, I would have called someone else and you'd be dead by now. Why don't you just give me the report, and I'll give you the money, and you can both go home. I'll put the money right here.
Keep it. I don't want it.
Sure?
Get the hell out of here.
She's all yours.
Mr. Clayton. Turn around. It's better if you don't look.
You come any closer and I'm gonna scream.
No one's gonna hear you.
The baker. But Clayton was here. He should have passed you.
He didn't.
Then he had to go up.
You wait here.
You took out Allison and Moonchase because you had to cover your tracks. But why Graves? Was it drugs?
He made me look like a fool.
You killed him for that?
He slept with my wife. He humiliated me in front of important people. I live here. Who the hell did he think he was?
Kansas, I guess it's all over.
Well, not quite. I'm a little stuck here.
Oh, don't worry. You'll love it here in Vegas.
Maggie!
Says Steve was killed because of a domestic argument with a man named Clayton. You're not trying to shield me from something, are you, Evan? I'll make it easier for you. I know there were other women. I was his wife, remember? But did Steve ever say? Was there something that I...
No. Claire. It's just that... Look, Steve took the wrong road and he got lost, right? It happens, Claire. Could have happened to me.
What about the IAD investigation?
It's over. What Steve did, he did on his own. The department's clean. That's all they care about. Look, for whatever it's worth, that night at the junkyard, I think he was just doing his job. And he was killed in the line of duty.
You know, you didn't have to come here and put yourself through this.
Yes, I did.
You've been a good friend. Thank you, Evan.
Thank you.